Hi everyone, today we are going to see about the concept of inheritance in C++. Inheritance is one of the key concepts of C++. Inheritance is the ability to inherit the properties of base class to derived class. Here, base class is parent class and derived class is child class. Creating new class from existing class is known as inheritance. Let us see the example of inheritance. She had inherited the beauty of her mother. This is an example of inheritance. Mother's beauty is inherited to child. Advantages of inheritance. Reusability is the main advantage, and second advantage is it reduces the size of the program. Types of inheritance. Single inheritance, multiple inheritance, hierarchic inheritance, multi-level inheritance, hybrid inheritance. This is the syntax of inheritance. Let us see about the single inheritance. If a single class is derived from a single base class, it is called as single inheritance. Multiple inheritance. If a class is derived from more than one base class, it is called as multiple inheritance. Multi-level inheritance. If a class is derived from a derived class, it is called as multi-level inheritance. Hierarchy inheritance. If a number of classes are derived from a single base class, it is called as hierarchical inheritance. Next one is hybrid inheritance. It is a combination of one or more types of inheritance. Example, multiple inheritance and multi-level inheritance are combined to form a new form of hybrid inheritance. Thank you. Next topic is polymorphism in C++. Polymorphism. Let us see the definition. Polymorphism allows the same function to act differently in different classes. Poly means multiple and morph means forms. Let us see the types of polymorphism. First one is compile time for polymorphism. Compiler is able to select the appropriate function for a particular call at the compile time itself. This is called as static binding or static linking or compile time polymorphism. It is called as early binding. Next, second type of polymorphism is runtime polymorphism. Binding means connecting one program to another program that is to be executed in reply to the call. Dynamic binding is also known as late binding or runtime polymorphism. Next, we are going to see about the virtual functions in C++. When we use the same function in both base class and derived class, the function in base class is declared as virtual function using the keyword virtual preceding its normal declaration. This is an example of virtual function. Function in base class is declared as virtual. Next, unit 5, streams in C++. C++ data streams. C++ supports a rich of IO functions. A stream is a sequence of bytes, or stream is a flow of bytes. The source stream that provides data to the program is called input stream, and the destination stream that receives output from this program is called output stream. Input stream. The source stream that provides data to the program is called input stream. Output stream. The destination stream that receives output from the program is called output stream. C++ stream classes. This is a block diagram of C++ stream classes. iStream. This is also known as input stream. It inherits the properties of iOS object. The iOS stream class is a derived class. It is derived from iStream and OStream. OStream. This is also known as output stream. It inherits the properties of iOS. Declare output functions like put and write. Put and write. If stream, it provides input operations. OF stream, it provides output operations. F stream, it provides support for simultaneous input and output operations. Operations of a file in C++. These are the basic operations: file name, opening the file, reading or writing the file, detecting errors in the file, closing the file. Opening the file. To open each file, we use the following syntax: file.open, enclosed with the parameters. Next, closing the file. This is the syntax followed in the closing the file in C++. Next, reading or writing the file and file opening modes. Syntax. These are the syntax followed in C++. Here, iOS input output stream object. BEG is beginning of file, and CUR is current position of file, and end is end of file. Thank you.